Hi, my name is Leslie Gossett, and welcome to Leslie's List. In each episode, I will introduce you to my favorite boutiques, neighborhoods, and standout businesses in the Austin area. Today, we are here with style extraordinaire Ricky Hodge of Third Space Salon. Tell me, where are we? What is this amazing place?
So this is Third Space Salon, and where we're at right now is the outside of it. So we converted this little space into a little salon because of COVID, but also because Texas weather. Sometimes it's really nice at night if we're working, we can turn on the lights and just work out here and just have a nice little breezeway.
You've got a real life salon chair, you've got a mirror. natural light.
Kind of boho chic,
very cool. So beautiful, yeah. Very different. You're probably the first and only outdoor COVID
totally salon. Works, it looks great on Instagram, and it's nice to just like be outside.
Awesome.
Yeah, especially if you're gonna be in a process that takes, you know, like a couple hours.
Well, I'd like to start off by just asking you, what drew you to this industry?
Well, I mean, hair is like, you know, something that we all have, most of us. But fashion was one of it. You know, just being creative was another part of the reason I wanted to do hair. But it all started with me actually wanting to become a chef. And I was 35, 36 years old whenever I decided to take another career path. And I just thought that, you know, being a chef, I wouldn't be famous until I was like 50. And I thought working in the kitchen would take a long time. So I thought, what could I do? And I thought, oh, I'll just do hair, make the money, and eat at these great restaurants, which is actually what I've done, so.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
What do you think sets you apart from the hundreds of stylists?
There's a lot of stylists, and they're all very good. There's a lot of really good stylists everywhere. I don't claim to be the best. I never want to be the best. I always want to strive for something. But I feel like, you know, part of the thing that set me out in front of a lot of people was how I branded myself. And branding myself was really kind of a stumble onto it. I started wearing a bow tie every day, and then I started getting interviews about my style. And then I started to realize that I was actually branding myself. Branding myself didn't make me better, but it threw me out in front of a lot of people that were actually really good. So surrounding myself with that talent also helped because it made me look good. So
that's a good segue into another question I was dying to ask, which is who are some of your style icons?
Wow. It's
got
not
such original style. It's so great.
I mean, you know, for guys, I feel like you can open up a magazine. I feel like it's pretty much just anybody that's in a magazine. It doesn't have to be someone that's famous. A person that has really good style is just really from within. So you can see a person walking by and say, God, that guy is like great. I like their style. But it really just, I mean, sometimes I put things together and people would be like, I could never do that, but I think it comes with confidence.
And the authenticity,
yeah,
just shines through.
It just shines through.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where do you go to keep up with the latest trends for hair?
Well, I mean, you know, thank God we have social media. That's a huge avenue towards what is relevant, what's current. But part of my whole thing is really kind of travel. Like when you travel, you get inspirational. It doesn't have to really be about hair. It doesn't really have to be about fashion. It just has to be something that's going to get your blood going. So it can be like architecture. It can be like just visiting another city or visiting a city that you actually like. You come back with that energy of just being, you know, vivacious and just happy and wanting to try something different.
What's your favorite sort of niche within the industry?
Well, I'm actually known to do a lot of blondes. It's what I kind of made my name with. And of course I love it because that brings the most money. But at the end of the day, I like the technical skills of like men's haircuts. I don't use clippers. I actually use scissor over comb. I can get it pretty tight to the skin. I measure the haircuts always with the mirror and making sure that it's pretty tight against the skin. As far as blondes are concerned, I mean, I love a high maintenance blonde. That sounds kind of ridiculous, but those are the ones that are bright and they have just a brightness to their hair. So I get to see them often, but I feel like it's also a style of color that is kind of gone away because people tend to want more of a lived in, less maintenance look, but I still feel like there are a lot of people that like that high maintenance, bright blonde. And so that's what I do.
You're slowly getting me there.
Yeah, slowly. We'll get there.
Yeah. What is, what are some of your favorite products?
I love Orbe. I think it's the most consistent. I use Goldwell for color, I love Goldwell. I've used it pretty much my whole career. I've ventured off to try some other things. And then as far as like, you know, people will say, oh, I use this organic shampoo or conditioner. To me, I feel like organic things in the hair world tend to dry it out. So I really kind of steer away from that. But I love nothing too sticky. I definitely like high shine. I feel like when men tend to put like matte color in their hair, I feel like it really looks more dry. So when you put something a little bit shinier, it just looks healthier. So I like a healthy looking hair. So that's kind of like my go-tos.
What do you see yourself in 5 years?
I really like where I'm at, but I kind of want to travel a little bit and do hair. It's kind of hard to do that because you really kind of have to have a foundation of clients. So I love traveling either with my client or meeting them in a certain place like Big Sur and going there to do something. But traveling and doing hair tends to be like kind of a focus for the near future for myself.
Cool, that's awesome.
Yeah.
The last time I was in your chair, we talked about sort of how in your industry you tend to attract the clients that mm-hmm. you want that resonate with
yeah.
you. On that note, what are some words that you live by?
I feel like, you know, as far as they've always said to us, in school that you tend to attract people a lot like yourself in your chair. I like to think that all of my clients are pretty awesome and pretty fabulous, so I hope that I am because I attract them. But that's all a matter of opinion of what you think that is. As far as words to live by, one of the things that I live by is that we all fall down. And it's about not what happens then, but how you recover from that. We are not made to be perfect, and so when you stumble and fall, it's about how you actually go forward instead of like trying to figure out what it is that you did wrong, because we all make mistakes. And so my motto is just to get up and just keep on going.
I love
yeah.
that.
Yeah,
thank
it's a good
you.
Thing. Yeah,
yeah, that's beautiful.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for your time, Ricky.
Thanks,
for
Leslie.
Those of you that are looking for a new stylist, reach out to Ricky, come in for a consult. He will take very good care of you.
Yeah. RickyHodge.com. And I also do Zoom consultations.
Awesome.
Yeah, I think it's great. It's kind of like the new normal. So.
Cool.
Yeah.
Very cool. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.